In the video today, we're answering a viewer question because Noah A. asks us, why do roosters crow in the morning? Next to the bark of a dog or the gentle meowing of a cat, the crow of a rooster is one of the most recognizable animal noises on Earth. But why exactly do roosters feel the need to crow? And is there any truth to the idea that they crow more or only in the morning? Surprisingly, although chickens are one of the most ubiquitous and delicious animals on the planet, it wasn't until 2013 that scientists definitively answered these questions. First of all, it's important for us to point out that roosters will crow at all times and in response to a range of seemingly innocuous stimuli, like the sound of a car or someone walking into their coop. This is because the crow of a rooster serves several functions, along with being used as a warning of sorts to let other roosters know the boundaries of its territory. The crow can be used to communicate with other birds and sometimes to celebrate getting lucky. Roosters really aren't very picky when it comes to excuses for crowing. That said, although roosters have been observed crowing at all times of the day and in response to even the most mundane of stimuli, they will indeed typically crow just before or at the crack of dawn. Because of the rooster's tendency to crow at everything for many years, scientists and bird nerds, who are officially known as ornithologists, were under the impression that roosters crowing at daybreak was simply crowing in response to the changing levels of light. However, after years of anecdotal stories about roosters seemingly knowing when daybreak was about to occur, scientists at Nagoya University in Japan decided to see if this was all just in people's heads, or if roosters really were anticipating rather than reacting to the sunrise. In the research helmed by Takashi Yoshimura, several experiments were run on roosters to answer these questions. To start, roosters were exposed to different environments for a couple of weeks. As expected, with all groups, the roosters crowed at all times of day in response to a variety of stimuli, like being fed. So, what about the mornings? Well, first, a group of roosters were exposed to an environment where it was light for 12 hours, then dark for 12 hours, and that was repeated for 2 weeks. As many have previously posited, the roosters really did anticipate the light, generally starting their pre-dawn crowing at about 2 hours before the light was to turn on. Another observation was that the most dominant rooster would be the one who started the crowing off. This lent credence to the idea that crowing is about marking territory and asserting dominance. As Yoshimura stated, "Our preliminary data suggest that the highest-ranked rooster has priority in breaking the dawn, and lower-ranking roosters are patient enough to wait and follow the highest-ranked rooster each morning." In a second experiment, roosters were exposed to a constant near-dark environment for 24 hours per day. Despite this, Yoshimura and his colleagues noted that the roosters quickly settled into a 23.8-hour day and would begin crowing the same time every day. The light seemingly didn't seem to factor in here, and the roosters always crowed before dawn. Going further, when Yoshimura's team tried to trick the birds by randomly exposing them to bright lights or loud sounds at various times, while this did induce some crowing, they consistently responded more strongly to the stimuli, they crowed more, when it occurred around what would normally be considered dawn. Yoshimura et al. Concluded that the birds must have an internal body clock that tells them when to crow. Furthermore, due to the fact that roosters can't be tricked into crowing at other times of the day as strongly as they do around dawn, the researchers concluded that their internal clocks take precedence over external cues. As for why roosters seem to love to crow in the mornings, this isn't fully understood, but is thought to be tied with the aforementioned notion of crowing being primarily about announcing territory and where a particular rooster sees itself on the pecking order. This would also explain why roosters seem to crow in response to things like the sound of cars. The roosters assume such noises must be a potential rival and responding kind. Similarly, when being given food, the crowing acts as a way for them to assert that it's their food. And of course, in the morning after a good night's rest, they are re-announcing to the world their presence at the very first opportunity. And now for some bonus facts. Although it's often portrayed as being a behavior exclusively observed in roosters, female chickens can and sometimes do crow. And now for another bonus fact. Contrary to popular belief, both a wolf's howl and a duck's quack echo. Wolves have even been known to use this to their advantage when hunting, making it sound like there are more wolves around than there really are. Further, wolves do not howl at the moon. This would give away their position and invite attack from wolves from another pack. Wolves have even been known to kill their own young if they don't learn when it's appropriate to howl and when it's not appropriate. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. And do not forget to subscribe. We've got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. And if you're looking for something else to watch right now, click on one of the videos on the screen now. And as always, thank you for watching. Roosters will crow at all times in response to a large variety of seemingly innocuous stimuli, like the sound of a car or someone walking into their coop. It's coop, right? You don't want someone to walk into their chicken coop. First of all, it's important for us to point out that roosters will crow at all times and in response to a seemingly